never stop, no, I don't quit. And when I swing, I don't miss. You ain't never seen nothing like this, yeah. Yeah. You ain't seen nothing like this. Come on and give me some more. We're gonna shake the floor. I bust down the door. You ain't seen nothing like this. Come on and give me some more. We're gonna shake the floor. I bust down the door. You ain't seen nothing like this. Give me some more. We gon' settle the score. Spread my wings and soar. You ain't seen nothing, nothing like this. You ain't seen nothing, nothing like this. You ain't seen nothing like this.
Hello guys, welcome to another Rusty in Places live stream. I'm joined today by one of our newer members to the clan. He's interested in getting started in streaming and he's going to be commentating today with me, Wookie Cookie.
Yo, what's up guys? Thanks for having me.
Pleasure, mate. We've got a very interesting event today. It's a special Fight Club event. One Life themed initially, with a bit of a twist. At the moment, we're in the staging period where the squads have been assembled. The kits will be assigned via the squad leaders, and there'll be an in-game briefing given by the admins at the moment. The brief scenario is that the insurgent forces have got a anti-aircraft vehicle that they're trying to defend and extract from a point. Whereas the Russian forces, yes, they will be trying to infiltrate that area. So we've probably got about another 5 minutes at the moment of the staging time, by which point we will be live and be able to show you more of the action.
Exciting stuff. Are you able to tell us a little bit more about Squad itself? For those joining us who haven't played this game before?
Yeah, for sure. So Squad is the spiritual successor to Project Reality, an old Battlefield 2 mod initially. Since then, it's gone under a lot of changes. It's a complete standalone game now, developed on the Unreal 4 engine. In the last week or two, we've had the version 10 release, which a lot of people have been waiting for quite a while now. It's changed the whole meta of the game now completely. All animation update, vaulting systems have been in place. There's a lot more weapon sway with weapons and stuff. Site overhauls. There's huge change log to check out on the Join Squad website. It's very interesting. I'm going to be looking forward to seeing how this pans out now, because the traditional way of attacking and defending has been changed a lot now by the new style of animations and the vaulting and stuff. So.
Course, yeah. I mean, we played alongside each other. The gameplay within the last even sort of week or so has changed dramatically. So it'll be very interesting to see how this is played out in a competitive scenario.
Yeah, I mean, one thing that's going to be different to a normal squad event is obviously this is based on a one life. So medics will be allowed to revive, but once you're down and dead, that's it. You're out of the game. So I imagine the pace of combat will slow down initially. We'll be looking for use of buddy system, so people going in pairs or, you know, a fire team, rather than a whole squad pushing up in force, because if they get wiped, that's it, you know.
Nice.
Possible implementation of point man as well, so they'll just go in as, you know, the entry fragger, gauge how the contact is inside compounds and stuff. I don't know what is going to happen until we get in there. Every squad is different. Every squad leader has their own take on things. So yeah, let's see what unfolds.
Interesting. So just to emphasize that and reiterate that a little bit more, they literally have one life, and that's it.
That's it, yeah. So they can get incapacitated into a down state, which I think, depending on I think the level of damage, you have about 2-3 minutes of down state, so a medic can still get you in that time. You have the function to give up, which in a normal squad match you would then respawn at a rally point, FOB, or your main base. In this instance, you will not have that luxury. If you give up, that's it, you're out of the game. So the pressure is really on to cover your medics, you know, cover your buddies, make sure that, you know, you're looking after the squad as and the team as well.
And everyone playing tonight is it's part of the RIP clan, is that correct?
Yeah, this is a exclusive RIP only event for now. It's our first time running a custom event such as this. We've done other fight clubs before, but none in the scale of this other fight club. The numbers initially just for a trial were 9v9, but there's been an extreme interest within the clan, so it's been bumped to an 18v18 at the minute.
And these are all regular players who play with each other on almost a daily basis?
Some, yeah. Most of these guys are, we have a platoon within the clan called the Warthogs. That's our match team. Some of the guys as well are more of the casual basis, so they'll just be playing on our public servers. We have RIP versus the World on a Friday as well, where you can come and challenge us. All public are welcome, where we stack up on one team just for once a week. The rest of the time we will try and balance our servers and introduce as much open and public play as we can. So yeah, it's going to be a nice mix of player base today as well. We're going to see some veterans and some newbies alike.
Awesome. It sounds like it's going to be really intense. I've never seen anything like this in terms of event before. So, and you said you're not quite sure what to expect. I think I'm excited to see it start.
Yep. So I think we're getting ready now. The staging time is nearly over. Over towards Russian faction from my side. I believe, Wookie, you're on the militia, the insurgent faction side.
That's right. I'm with the guys at the staging area now. They look just about ready to go.
Yeah, looks like we're getting ready to go now. So just transition.
Here we go.
Game is live. Get a squad myself so I can hear my squad leader comes over this side.
Great stuff. And team killing, is it activated? Is team killing a thing?
Team killing is a thing. Friendly fire will happen. There is no punishment for it. But it's not good when it happens.
The loss of pride, I think, and the humiliation from your teammates, like I would probably expect.
Yes, definitely. So we can see the Russian forces now sending out a squad straight away on the far eastern road heading north. Second squad is slowly following up behind.
We've got a slow start by the looks of it from the insurgent side.
I think both sides are trying to be a little bit cautious at this early stage.
Understandable. Well, the last thing you'd want is a transport full of a squad or half a squad taken out at an early stage. It'd be a huge loss.
Yeah, so already the Russians have started to deploy troops on the ground. Trying to cover the armour as well.
What sort of tactics are we expecting to see in a scenario like this in terms of the objectives and the main objective at hand?
Well, on the Russian side, you obviously want to scout out the area as early as you can. Try and gauge the amount of forces that you're going to come up against. If it's a full squad, if it's two squads in there, they obviously, if they've got any scouts on the outside. With obviously the introduction of version 10, how they actually come to assault the compound is yet to be seen. I'm hoping to see some scaling over the walls using the vaulting system. It's going to be very interesting.
It's going to add a whole new dynamic to especially a scenario like this as well. Sort of flanking and coming in from what would normally be considered a blind side. Do you think that these players are ready for the changes? Do you think they're used to the changes implemented within version 10?
I think a lot of the old dogs, you might say, it's going to be interesting to see how they adapt and change their usual game style. It's compounded by the fact that this is a one life event as well. It's not just something that you can just, you know, smoke up at a compound, pre-nade, and then push in. There's still that risk of death quite early on. So you can see that these Russian forces here have dismounted the armoured vehicle, and they're trying to spread out as best as they can, covering each other. So there's a nice spread already at this early stage.
From what you've seen so far, do you see anything special coming in from the Russian side? Any sort of aggressive or...
No, it's very, very slow, very passive. Obviously, their briefing has given them a rough indication of where the contact will be, but they have actually no idea where they could come into engagement, so they're taking things nice and slowly.
Excellent. So and it looks like they're going to be hitting from, what is it, at this stage they're dismounted and spread across two to three points?
So at the minute there's two squads over on the Russian side. You've got one on the far eastern flank, which is pushing up the northern road, and then you have the majority of the forces in the middle of the map as well, again dismounted from the armoured and supporting it in a staggered column either side. What can you see over from the insurgents so far? How are they setting up?
It looks like they're spread out very, very nicely in amongst a lot of the compounds within the area of operation, which would indicate that they're looking to probably draw enemies in and take two or three out as they attempt to breach into the sort of into the city, if you'd like.
It's not about the points. Ignore the points.
Which is a very interesting tactic. It doesn't look like they're going to be able to cover each other that much. So the medics are probably going to be spread quite thin, I would probably say, from an early stage. And they're certainly, if they've got two, three Russians breaching a room, they're certainly going to be under a lot of pressure to take as many as possible.
Yeah, for sure. Again, very, very slow approach here on the Russian side. The armour just pushing up the road, utilising that staggered column of infantry either side.
And what was the objective? Can you go over the objective for us again?
So the brief objective is the Russian forces have a anti-aircraft side bob, and they have to exfiltrate that area AO, and the Russian forces have been sent on a strike force to try and eliminate the troops and remove that emplacement as well. The vehicle, so.
Excellent. It looks very lightly defended at the moment. I don't know if that's going to change once they know which area they're going to be engaged from.
Yeah, some of the particulars as well from the mission briefing I'm aware of are that the fields have been mined. So in this instance, we are having to stick to the actual MSRs as opposed to normally traversing across the open fields. So the risk there is implemented with the use of mines of a threat.
Wow, so vehicles only on roads, no off-roading?
That's right, yes. So again, it slows the pace down a lot more because obviously they're having to stick to the MSRs. The last thing they want to do is push through a village or a cap point and find that there's a ambush waiting for them. So that's why the pace is really slowed down.
Nice. A lot of running around coming in from the insurgent side. I think they're still trying to figure out where they want to be at this moment in time and still waiting for that first engagement.
Have a look at the insurgent side. So Russians are still a good couple of villages away at the moment, taking their time, whereas the insurgents are very much up against time, where they have to get themselves taken into a position where they can defend that objective.
Have we got that second squad of Russians? Have they come all the way around? On the completely the opposite side, almost.
They are on the far eastern flank, pushing upon that northern road. So they're now almost parallel with the insurgents, so they will have to push direct to the west, assuming they have accurate intel on where the insurgents are located.
Awesome. So we're definitely going to be seeing potentially a stealthed squad coming in.
Possibly. I heard some early signs of some shots there. I don't know if somebody's been contact there or.
Sex shot, you in contact?
Excited by a bush?
No, we were just making sure they weren't hiding. Okay,
so someone's just trying to bait out the enemy there just by a bit of refire. So we've located the anti-aircraft gun inside this compound here. This is the prize. This is the objective that the insurgents will be defending with their lives, be it all one of them this time round. Where is the objective?
So the location of this, the objective here, that's going to obviously make a huge difference to the scenario of the attacking Russian side. Do you think that they've got enough defences here, based on where the Russians are at the moment and the angle they're going to be coming in from?
I think the defences are quite small at the moment, but I am unaware of their logistics supply. I don't know if they're having to deal with what they've got and they're just defend from out. Again, the usual defence tactics prior to version 10 would be you'd cover doorways, you know, windows, any easy point of entry, whereas now, with the installation of the vaulting system, there are no safe areas. Previously, you would have had to get a ladder up on a wall. Now you can just get your buddy to crouch down below that wall and scale over his head. So,
that's cool. I know, easy.
Do you see that adding more sort of influence and more pressure to the defending side, or
definitely?
I
think it's going to be nicely balanced with the aspect of it's a one life system. Fact that they know that they don't just want to push in straight away and breach.
Bear in mind the timing. 20 minutes left. Before insurgents,
do you think we're going to see a lot of long-range fighting initially, and it finishing off with a lot of close-quarters fighting? I think it's going to be close quarters quite early on.
There may be a couple of long-range engagements once they get spotted, but it's going to be quite close-quarters initially. So, just a bit of extra intel for you here, for the guys watching on the stream. We have also found out that the insurgents have got like another 20-minute staging time. The initial defense squad on that objective, then they get reinforcements.
So
the Russians are also against a time scale, and not only do they have to storm that compound and take out that AA, they are also against time.
That's not what you want when you're attacking a facility, really. They're going to be rushing around those corners straight into AK fire, really.
But they also don't want to wait too long and find out that their reinforcements have made it an impossible task to breach.
Interesting. Cool. The Russians are really making ground on that east flank there, coming up just the road away.
So we're just going to push on that eastern flank and capture that now. Yeah. So the southern Russian squad are one village away, but their armoured vehicle is drawing a lot of attention that way. You can definitely hear that from a long way away. As we come along now and we see this eastern flank.
We'll
likely
see the first rounds landing any minute.
Yeah, so we can see insurgents just peering over the wall. No direct eyes on at the moment. But he's looking in the general direction of where that Russian squad is. Great utilization of using the terrain here from the Russian squad. Not skylining on that little ridge line. Down in the edge of the field.
They're really hugging that ridge to get in. Unseen completely.
Utilising a little bit of spacing there as well, making sure that there's plenty of a gap between them if the frag grenade comes across.
There is only, you're looking at 3 to 4 insurgents actually defending this side as well.
Yep, so they've spread quite thin at the moment. Possibly 1-2 compound as such. But the piano fight's covering north there, Skaggy Man and Reap. Southern. They will be the AA is probably southeast of the flag itself. They've got to push in from that northern side, push all the way through. There's no accurate intel, as far as I'm aware, from the Russians to know the exact location of the AA as well. So
the first shots are going to be coming in.
Very much like an insurgency game mode where you'd have to locate the cache. You've got an indication, but no actual accuracy.
Roger, guys, I want this first part of this compound searched and cleared.
Piano fights in it. There we go. The first blood is drawn.
The piano fights there. Prone, covering that doorway. Razor wire up inside it as well.
Brilliant position. Brilliant. What just happened? Was that a grenade?
Yeah, so we've got the Russian forces now starting to nade the compound. Aware of.
We're in contact. Yeah, we'll push up
now. Oh, there's a second kill. No movement from the rest of the insurgents.
Got him.
Gunner fight say gets taken out by a nade. Up there by Dildo McBaggins.
There's only three of us left, me, you and Cloak.
But they're not aware that he's down. Yeah, is that right?
Yep, that's it, he's down. What's interesting is I don't think some people are getting the grasp of it's a one life event, so if you're downed, you can get revived. Less.
Some more trading shots here between the insurgents on the east side between Reaper and Easy, it looks like. Now down to a three-man squad on the east.
So the southern Russian squad now pushing up with their armoured vehicle. Insurgents just trying to gauge it out. Wouldn't want to go for any long open range engagements at this point because that armoured would push them.
Pushing too easy.
But there's been one RPG strike already on that Russian vehicle.
How many can it take?
Unsure at the moment. I think it's about three heat rounds.
Oh wow! On the east side there, we've lost two Russian reinforcements. Reaper taking out two, just over the side of the wall. Only easy left on the east side.
Sector, you're almost way.
Been hit one.
Incredible play by Reaper on the east. Easy on the east side, looking for another entrance, it looks like.
Jaggy man there covering the east side as well. Nice to see the guys sticking to their sectors as well, not just moving around once the contact gets it.
And I think that's certainly proved its worth on this east flank here. Piano doing what he needed to do in that small compound there, being taken out and then letting Reaper finish off the majority of the rest of the squad on the east flank. Heavy losses already for the Russians.
Now at the approach from the south, we can see the Russians pushing the western flank now. MTLB remaining at distance.
Have you spotted the AA gun, Easy?
Oh, negative.
Russians calling out there, looking for intel on where that AA is.
Looks like the Russians are taking fire in the fields. Future Force, a couple of really good shots there on Trixie. Oh, the RPG is going out. Trixie's down. BBN six shot, looks like BBN has to play it there, six shot is down. Grenade going out.
Utilization of smoke here now from the Russian side on that western. Some of the guys trapped in the open field, it's not where you want to be. Bit of a killing zone.
Certainly
there.
Not. Are these are these Russian smokes going out now?
There'll be Russian smokes trying to disguise that flank through the fields on the western side. You can see that Easy and Fox Legacy have made their way now all the way across into the northern side. Very close to
Dunkirk. Awesome shots. Oh, it looks like a medic down for the insurgents as well.
Easy choosing to flank underneath the roadways. pitching all the way along and linking back up with Six Shot Squad, Western Flank.
You get nine Six Shot.
Very nice. It looks like they've completely lost the east flank as well. No pressure on the east at all.
We have contact, heavy contact.
Are they grenade launcher rounds that we can hear coming in?
Yep, so that'd be a girl from the belief.
Can you talk us through the sort of range of weapons that we're likely to see on the field?
Without knowing the briefing, I'm unsure how the squad leaders would sign the kits. But we've got full utilisation of kits now as well. We've got the LMG. Obviously, we've seen the RPG being used from the insurgent side as well. We've got the GL as well from the Russian side. We did see very early on the first engagement was piano fights with the bipodded machine gun now, which is a new implementation from version 10.
Nice. So it looks like Vox is laying down that GL fire, really drawing some attention from the insurgent side, but not getting many kills.
He's just nading compounds just to make sure that they are clear, or is forcing the enemy to move around. They're not in one fixed position.
Excellent.
We can see that the MTLB now has moved all the way up on the far western flank, snug end inside there. Trying to cover the infantry from range. Trouble is with this western flank, there are a lot of murder holes, small doorways where the insurgents can just line up against, as we just see Goose go down from his heading.
And Vox, the GL on the southern flank, actually gets a kill with the rifle. Completely almost clearing out that south side there, only Future Force. And looks like we've got more Russians pushing in. I think they may have found a bit of a weakness in the insurgents' defences here. It'll be interesting to see how they play it.
Future Force just covering the road to them.
Oh, okay, are you alive?
It sounded like Insurgent Command, they're putting out a sub-briefing to the team, just letting them know they've got 10 minutes left until reinforcements arrive. So,
yo.
It looks already that there's dwindling numbers coming in from the Russian side.
Do you want to link up with me?
If you want to push in from that side, I'm going to try and... They kind of know where I am, so I've got to be really careful. I probably won't make it round to you. I'll try and push in sneakily from another side.
You have less than 10 minutes to complete your mission. Over. Copy.
The call out there, less than 10 minutes again.
Is there much that the Russians could do in this situation? I count maybe 3 to 4 troops still left in the AO and the armoured vehicle off to the north. Is there much left to play for them?
Initially, they're going to try and keep that from engagements. As we hear that now, opening fire. Looking to utilise that penetration as well. Just acting as some suppression while the infantry move on a flank around the northern sector. The Vox Legacy now pushed in on that eastern flank where we saw Easy throw and breach earlier.
Great time to move in as well. Yeah. I don't think you're going to see many insurgents actually.
We're just going to try to
seeing this, seeing it coming from Vox.
Yeah.
Is you're going to see Scandi Man come in.
Yeah.
Just around the corner.
Gaggy looking in the wrong direction. Will Vox see him as he comes around that corner of that compound?
Oh, he's taking the wall. Vox is taking the wall. In the back. Was that Bernie? A shot from the back, small doorway.
Very unfortunate. The marksman kit.
very unfortunate play by Vox.
Did well to breach inside there, that scaling of that wall, put him in the eyesight of Bernie. Whereas that armour is still softening up the forces on that western flank as we see Enwin and Squire.
Oh, Skaggy Man is down, it looks like. The last remaining Russian infiltrator is pushing in from the south here.
I think we should fall back.
Is he from another point? Got an interesting tactic here. Yeah. He's pushing in one spot, probing, then pulling back and trying somewhere else. So he's trying to always keep the insurgents guessing where their entry point will be from.
This future force going to see these guys running across the bridge.
They're going underneath the roadway there, so again, keeping themselves out of line of sight. That armoured vehicle utilising the suppression there, making sure the insurgents are not looking over the walls.
The insurgents almost seem completely unfazed, still holding their positions. Still very nicely spread out. The tactic seems to have worked very, very well for this stage.
Insurgents very open on the east, whereas the south western flank is still very much defended.
Is that the direction that the Russians are looking to head now?
They're pushing on that western flank now. Future Force close on that murder hole. He can hear the movement, they're very close.
Let's fall back.
Oh, it's in Future Force, can he get the shot?
There's a bit of stacking up there on the Russians. All very close to one another.
Future Force returning. Punishing them for retreating.
Sebastiu opening up.
Enwin in the open. Perfect time. Future Force is unbelievably lucky.
One guy on the street. Let me reload. Falling back.
So they're aware there's one guy looking on the road.
How much time do we...
Again, falling back under the road. Just constantly keeping the insurgents guessing. Not much time left now for the Russians. They need to put...
Great move.
Lots of insurgents still left alive at that point.
And lots of very experienced players as well. Uninspired.
This is Russian High Command.
Future Force,
we've seen
two very experienced players
getting closer to the valley. You have less than 5 minutes to complete your mission. Over.
Less than 5 minutes left now.
Oh, the flank! Enwin gets the kill on Future Force. Didn't even see it coming. Nothing he could do.
Snug end, pushing straight through the cap there.
Lots of aggression from the Russian, the last remaining three Russian infantry in the air. How far will they be able to push? Seb getting some shots in on Enwin. Great position by Seb. The absolute audacity of Snug End driving straight into the city with the armor and taking no RPG or anti-tank rounds.
He's actually bringing a lot of attention as well to the armored vehicle as opposed to the infantry.
Great move. He's going to be able to draw a lot of fire, a lot of attention away from the three remaining Russians. Oh, RPG round from the Russians going in there, Seb. Zeb, completely unfazed, takes Enwin out completely.
Just two Russians inside now. They are one compound away from the AA. Winsky there on the defense. Snug End still suppressing the infantry out to the two more infantry on the western side of. I think they have used all their heat rounds now. I think these two guys are the.
Loads of aggression from the Russian side at the perfect time. The odds were really stacked against them for the last couple of minutes. Oh, we got a, it looks like an anti-infantry round. Taking out Calzone Casper.
Unspire, last alive, very, very damaged. Down to about half of his health now. Patch. He hasn't used one of those already. That means he's only got one of those left. Peeking Seb.
Seb has definitely got the vantage point on him here.
Skylining, could get taken out by Bub. Lee's Swagger. Bastiu, shot in the back.
Oh, and it's down. That looks one, like GG.
One Russian left alive, which is snug end inside that MTL.
And by the amount of time that he spent in the centre of town here, it's suggesting that there's no heat rounds left. Is there much else he can do?
Yeah, so he's sat there in his lovely armor-plated vehicle without any opposition insurgents because they've utilized.
The audacity of it. Air conditioning on, he's probably got cracked open a nice cold one, just waiting for those guys to peek. It's almost like the Fury story.
Shots there coming out, trying to bait him.
Can he see the AA gun? He did it!
So he's got eyes on the prize, he's just looking to damage them now. But again, the insurgents are very limited at what they can do. Cause a distraction with smoke grenades, possibly.
Oh no! Unbelievable! Winston out!
He goes down, Bernie.
It's over. Bob Lee Swagger getting the last kill.
That was Bernie.
It was Bernie?
Yeah.
Unlucky snug end.
Bernie with the Sergeant Marksman kit there. Well done. Good job, guys.
Awesome kill by Bernie. That could have been over completely. That could have taken a completely different turn.
So, yeah, that was nice. Interesting round for sure, Wookie.
Very interesting round. I wasn't expecting it to be as intense as that. The Russians were massively on the back foot on the first engagement of the East Side. But there was no way I was expecting that that last push at the end to be as successful as it was.
So, we're going to have about a 5-minute break now, guys. I hope you enjoyed that first round. We're going to see how they've learned from their mistakes, what they did in that first round, and see what happens after the break. See you in a moment.
I got something else for Christmas too, hang on. Here we go.
The guitar. Ah, ukulele.
Ah, so peaceful.
Next scene.
Yeah.
Will there be a video? Make a video, man.
I'll make a video, Sammy. Oh shit! Oh, everyone's here! Oh, Christ!
Get out.
Oh,
that's terrible.
Do it!
Guys, you can fire into spot now.
Yeah, it's in the application.
But this is a fob. Find the cash! Come on, find the cash!
It's in here.
This is the cash! This is the one! Oh my god! Alright, again! We're in now! We can do it!
Is he on? He's aiming for you.
What do you say, 202?
He's aiming for you.
Oh, he saw me.
Yeah, it sure did. Right in the head, too.
I didn't see him, but he saw me. Right, I don't think he's friendly, okay,
what
guys?
What do you do?
What makes you think that?
That's why you need to wear a helmet. Big
hole in my head. Yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah.
No, Nagash, he's here.
No bad guys, I'm just going to be rally down.
Oh, what the hell? Where the
balcony is.
Dude.
The lower right window.
How the fuck did you end up with that?
Help!
Oh.
Getting off, buddy.
Oh, thank
you. Don't worry, Capital, you got three medics around you.
Three medics? I'll teach you a lesson about phasing.
Thanks.
To the moon!
Good luck with it.
So
on the road again. Yes, can't wait to get on the road again. Life is love is making you a good friend. And I can't wait to get on the road again.
Thank you.
Are you always making those YouTube videos?
Yes.
Yes, he is.
Yes, I am.
You need to make more of me in them. You're gonna make famous.
No, I'm not playing more of you, Team C. I don't want people to look bad.
Too young to die. Pick, just stay there, mate. I want to be patched. I'm coming. Don't you fucking die on me. No, Clipix. Living first! Damn it!
Did you die?
I died!
MRAP scope is clear. I can't see anything.
Come here. I'm gonna smoke him out. Just throw a grenade up these stairs. Yeah.
Where else should we go?
Tossing it.
Ah, bad frag. Get out.
Oh shit, bad.
I guess train bridge.
Oh, fuck.
Until you die, respawn with us.
Classic.
So I found a grenade on
him. Good work. Zah. Woo! Oh! It was inside the radio. Oh my god, the sneaky bastard.
Out the way.
I want to walk in.
Oh, stop, Lexi! Get this SPG out! Get the SPG on the road!
I'm ready.
Hey,
Everyone wait. Wait for the AT to get in place. Hey, is that a hat?
Yes!
Another vehicle. Oh, we fucking roll, man! There's a shitbox, same place. It's BTR!
BTR!
Guys, that was awesome. That was
Medic.
Great.
Are you truck? Logi? Come on, Rocket. Come out, Rocket.
Enemy Logi inbound side. Eyes on.
I hear
you. Last mover.
Let's see, shoot him.
One hit.
He's still moving. He's going fast.
I'll hit the truck.
Woohoo! Going fast, he's full.
Yeah!
Guys.
I got him, Pantero.
Yeah, it was moving east of the target.
Enemy, 1 o'clock high, on hill, 1 o'clock high.
Light armor, got stronger.
You said twice the height.
Far. It was
and
too fucking far.
Yeah, I know. You
it's
said twice the height
vehicle.
Of that. You said twice the height of that thing, and it didn't work.
Shit. It worked for me. And I landed low.
Somebody give it to somebody else. I mean, I'm not even looking through a range for landing, landing short.
See, that was twice.
And there we go. Who took that shot? You get middle of the fucking
day.
Yeah,
but we
nice
need one
swing.
More.
Yeah, we need one more rocket into that thing. Oh
right now, nice.
That shit is gone. Gone, gone. Dave, you get the asshole of the mission. That's a good thing.
So welcome back, guys. Just getting set up for the second round now. That was a very interesting first round for our first One Life event. What did you think to that, Wookie?
A lot more intense than I thought it was going to be, definitely. The One Life rule makes, I think, a huge difference to gameplay. I think some of the players potentially took a little bit of time to probably get used to that, and only towards the end did the Russian team really bring home and utilize the opportunity of a One Life on that sort of southeastern flank, definitely.
Yeah, so what we've had now is a little bit of feedback from the two guys who have organized this event. We've got TMK and Blackmail, two of our RIP members that have basically written the scenarios down and organizing the event for us tonight, so we thank you very much for that, guys. The feedback that they've had is that the balance was a little bit off at the moment, so the MTLB they thought was a little bit vulnerable, wasn't as enforcing as they'd like, so they're going to introduce a BTR this time round with the Russian side. Also, the objective will change slightly. I believe it's still trying to take out the anti-aircraft gun, but its location will be changed somewhat. So they've still got to have the interest of reaching into the village, locating the compound with the anti-aircraft, and then eliminating that as well before the insurgents get the reinforcements.
Awesome. So big props to the boys then for the efforts that have gone in so far. Because I can imagine these aren't easy to set up.
No, it takes a lot of their free time as well, and the scenarios, it's trying to keep it different each time around as well. You don't want it to be predictable, and you want that constant threat there as well. So the introduction of a time span as well is a great, great idea. Again, the incorporation of, you know, minefields, if you will, so they have to use the vehicles on the MSRs. So it gives the insurgents the chance to take a little flanking squad out, you know, provide some kind of an ambush possibly.
Excellent, excellent. So sort of bearing in mind how the first game played out, obviously the Russians lost a lot of men very early on. What sort of changes do you see happening this time? The sides are completely changing, is that right? So the attackers are now the defenders are now...
That's correct, yes. So we're going to see a switch of sides. I imagine both sides will have take what they saw and what they did themselves on the first round and then just try and change up a little bit more. Maybe some more breaching of over the walls. We saw a little bit that from Vox Legacy, but got shot in the back from Bernie. But again, it's very limiting on what you can do when it's just one person. I'd like to see some more utilization of the buddy system, possibly. Nice utilization of the staggered column with the MTLB early on from the Russian side as well, trying to protect that armor as best as it could. It only came into its own towards the end of the round. It provided a nice bit of suppression, allowing the squad to flank around, trying from different angles of approach. But we'll see. We'll see how they use it now. Obviously, we've got different sides using it now, so the attacking top side is now defending and vice versa. So we'll see how they implement it as well with the utilization of a BTR.
And the BTR being probably a slightly heavily armoured vehicle as well.
It's got a little more armour to it, yeah. I imagine that the insurgents will use some more hit-and-run tactics as well, which is what their, you know, the strengths are. They're not a... force that can be designed to attack at long range engagements, open fields. It's more quick strike force, close quarters. So we'll see.
And I'm guessing that in that case, the insurgents are more in their element when it comes to close quarters play.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, the insurgents, the loadouts that they get as well, is very much designed around CQB. But again, you need to have people in the right positions in that compound to cover it.
Excellent. So you could almost attribute it to the success of the first round, the insurgents really playing to their strengths. and spreading out, getting those CQB fights, taking the Russian out when they can.
Yeah, so the insurgents that were penned into the southwest corner, they were very much held in their positions. They didn't deviate too much from their designated areas. So that's what you need. You need people to be in the positions of a defence, so then you know that it's covered at all times.
Patience is key with an event like this. I think you'd agree.
Yeah, and again, it's a lot of a learning curve for everybody as well. This is the first One Life event that a lot of these people have played. So it's the uncertainty and that constant threat of death as well.
Excellent. So obviously the squad's now getting together, getting their briefings, etc. done. All the members here today, part of the Rip Clan. Tell us a little bit more about the Rip Clan itself.
The Rip Clan has been in place for over 11 years now. Some of the earlier games it played was Battlefield 2, Project Realities, probably where a lot of our members in squad have cut their teeth as well. It's got a lot of heritage. Some really old members of the clan as well still around playing as actively today as they did when they first joined, which is nice to see, sharing their experience as well.
And I think a really important message for the Rip Clan to the public is that anybody's welcome. Is that right?
Anyone over the age of 21 is the minimum stipulation. Our door is open to any nationality. We are a European-based clan. We normally play on the evenings on our public servers. We do host events such as this as well, exclusive for our members, with the possibility of some future open events coming in the future, seeing how this goes out, to get some feedback from the guys and if we think we're going to open it up. So there's a possibility of more community inclusion.
Awesome, and I think sort of the perfect example for that, Holland, is probably myself. I've been a RIP member now for just over a month, and I'm here on the stream with one of the most experienced members within the clan.
I wouldn't say I'm that experienced, but yeah, I've been here nearly 2 years myself now, so squad is a main staple within the Rusting Places, but we are a multi-gaming community as well, so we play all sorts of different games. Some were featured in the trailer that we showed you at the very start of the stream. Our main official supported games are Squad, Armour and Star Citizen. But we play lots of other different games as well on an unofficial basis. Just as a community, we can hang out and play together.
Excellent. If somebody wants to join the Rusty in Places clan, where would they find you guys?
So you just go and head over to our website, which is rustyinplaces.org. And fill in an application from there if you're interested in joining, and speak to one of our recruitment officers in our team speak as well, and they'll do the rest for you.
Awesome.
Apologies guys for the first round, I forgot to turn the official soundtrack off, so I didn't hear our voices as clearly as we'd like, but I won't make that mistake this time around. We are rusty in places. Okay, so I'm going to create my squad now. I imagine that the second round is going to get underway very shortly.
Sandbags, razor wire, and the barrels. You're not allowed to put ammo crates down, no HAB, no static guns or anything like that. You're allowed to use the AA also. That is it. Let's do it, boys.
Oh, yeah. The briefing coming to a conclusion there from the insurgents. They are getting ready to roll out right now.
Just get straight down to the south.
Looks like the Russians are now mounting up as well. Do you think we're likely to see the pace start similar to the first round?
I think it'll be slightly different from the insurgents now that they're aware that obviously what they can and cannot do. That they're going to try and get into the area of defence and lock that down as early as they can. Russians, again, are given, I believe, just a very rough indication of where they need to be. So the actual AA emplacement is in a different compound completely now. It's another part of the map. So they will have to try and push in and locate the AA as a priority and also be aware of insurgents' close quarters as well. It's a different compound which provides a lot more cover for the insurgents, but we might see a little bit more of the bolting and stuff with the Russian forces.
Excellent. And obviously bearing in mind that one life, that single life is all they've got, I think we'll likely see some really interesting play the second time, potentially even with the insurgents who are now the Russians, the blue team on this game, potentially even getting a little bit confident or maybe even cocky. Might be interesting to see how they utilise that.
Yeah, we're going to see what happens for sure. Rush tactics since version 10 have slowed down an awful lot. It's no longer a valid tactic because of not only have you had the implementation of the new animation system, so one of the things that was overutilized, I suppose, was the dolphin diving in V9. People would all of a sudden, as gaining contact, just take a nosedive to the ground. And that is
sort of from a running stance to then
just completely prone.
On the floor.
Yeah, within a second. Whereas you now have the animation that's slowed down. It actually the player has to go into the prone position and then also get up. And in that animation, you cannot fire your weapon or draw it up. So it slows the combat down an awful lot. It removes that habit, I suppose.
No, that's the amazing thing about the squad community, I think, is the squad developers take on board that information, that feedback from the community, and then make the changes to the game to improve the experience.
Yeah, it's trying to make the game so it's as playable and as fair for everybody. You know, this isn't your Call of Duty style game. This isn't even Battlefield. This is a combined warfare. It's designed for 50v50 troops. We're not at that stage yet. At the minute, the maximum numbers are 40v40, but we're hoping now that obviously we've got the new animation system update and the optimization passes, we might see the implementation of 100-man servers with combined warfare, as I say, vehicles and infantry on the ground. There's lots of different assets being added to the game with each version drop as well, so it's going to be interesting to see how the game pans out. It is still in early access, alpha, sorry, but it's a very playable game.
Certainly, I mean, I doubt you're going to be able to get many games on the market at the moment. At alpha stage to this quality, the graphics are simply beautiful. The scenery is phenomenal, the detail is incredible. Nearly all of the buildings, are accessible as well, is that correct?
Yeah, all buildings are accessible. Obviously now, most of the height is accessible as well with the vaulting system. It allows you to get to areas in maps before that you were never able previously to access.
And there's almost the sort of sandbox element in terms of amending the terrain with being able to build sort of in-game units or in-game buildings. Tell us a little bit more about that.
So you have the introduction of the forward operating base. So you'll have to deploy a radio, which we can see in the middle of our map below us. And what you're not seeing in this game, because it's a one-life event, is you will have a hab as well. A hab is where the friendly troops will spawn at from that forward operating base, and then you can then utilize different fixed emplacements, sandbags, so you can use that as a defended area. If you lose that area as well, you do lose tickets as well, so the risk is associated with having too many forward operating bases. You can lose more tickets just by having those taken out.
There's sort of quite a few elements to actually take into account, especially when you're setting up forward operating bases, etc. as well. Even losing men, losing armor, you lose quite a few tickets if you lose armor as well, is that right?
That's right, yeah. Each asset has got a different ticket value. It also has a respawn time value as well, so it will not come back into the round after a certain allotted time. So we're seeing now that the insurgents have implemented a roadblock. Russians pushing up very aggressively early on.
MTLB coming up the road. Roger, just got the call.
That's very aggressive early on. And I've noticed here the insurgents, which were the Russians in the last game, have got a few what looks like scouts or marksmen or sharpshooters. We've got Vox out on the southwest side.
Yeah, so he's really off the point there. He's going to be a scout for the insurgents, trying to give as much intel early on to the guys who are inside the compound defending. Call out has already come from the insurgents that they are aware of that MTLB's location. It switched its engine off so to avoid its pinpoint accuracy from the insurgents, but they are it's a known location. Insurgents. Unspire as well. They're also doing a similar tactic to Vox in the field to the south.
What's the likelihood of these Russians either rolling into Uninspire or being able to see him from this ridge up in the north?
I think as long as he stays where he is, he's relatively good cover. At the minute, from that angle, he cannot see them, nor can they see.
Great move, great move.
MTLB firing off a couple of early shots, softening up the infantry inside the compounds.
Keeping the heads down so the team can move into the southwest.
So there's a flank coming with the infantry on the far west, south of Vox for now, but they will be pushing parallel, I think, to the compound then across. Also, the infantry cannot go into the water either on this single life event. They're very much forced sticking to the so the second squad for the Russians is all south of the river.
Yeah, so I've got a couple of guys into the field, so basically when Enwin they push up,
pushing out, probing on the far
the
east
village, they'll come in and finger blast them.
Sorry, sexual officer, we have a sir.
Interesting move from the insurgents this time, actually breaching out of the compound itself.
A little bit more aggressive, utilising those scouts, their point men. So they've got one out to the south, one out to the
east. Oh, Enwin really is out on the flank by himself. He's now falling back, I'm guessing, because he's seen them.
He has to be careful on that ridge line because he will be seen, yeah. John Poodle probably has eyes on. But he's probably told not to engage early on stage. Want to get as close as they can without actually firing.
Great move, great move.
The Don, really slow roll. Enwin possibly got eyes on. Might be the first contact.
Uninspired directly focused on the infiltrating Russians. He knows exactly where they're coming from.
Slowly crawling up. Crouch position. Enwin fixed. Obviously, a moving target is easier to spot than a static. And we're actually pushing out now as Don Poodle pushes into that position. We get shot in the back. MTLB opening up fire.
Shooting at Goost in the city, just trying to keep his head out of that window. I think Goost fired off a couple of shots as he saw some of those Russians peeping their heads over the parapet. No kills. Vox is actually getting a really nice flank in on the Russians on the
south
side as well.
Southeast of the camp.
Enwin has called out the location of a full squad to the south. Got that engagement going on now.
The the Russians are actually making really, really good ground. Unspire still in the field.
Is just ahead of you. He's
keeping his head down. He's got three Russians moving directly up.
They're going to walk straight over him if they're not careful. Unspire looking the wrong direction at the wrong time. Very close. Fjell going to stand on him. He's going to walk.
Couldn't get any more attention than this. Oh, he walked straight into him.
So, yeah, the Russians really, really, really close down the south.
Unfortunate play by Unspire there. I felt like he could have done some serious damage to the Russians. We do have Vox, the other scout on the south side, is actually infiltrated right behind the enemy lines there. Almost actually allowed Bob Lee Swagger to push all the way through, keeping his eyes open.
Yeah, so Bob Lee Swagger not actually looking behind him either, Bob looking to the east. Vox Legacy looking the same direction. No, he's looking south behind a tree, so Bob's lucky there that he's not looking in that direction. Could get seen.
Vox could do some serious damage if utilized properly, or just completely wasted if he allows the opportunity to pass him by.
Difficulty that he faces as an insurgent, though, is he's using iron sights, so he doesn't have the scoped advantage there. Sudden attacking force now right on that wall.
Wow, they have moved up. BBM getting some good shots again. Calzone Casper taking some serious hits there. Now needing to take a step back and bandage himself up.
So the key thing to listen out for now is if you get really close to the action, you can hear the actual sound of the enemy movement.
And that's just going to add sort of another level of hyper-realism to the game.
Indeed, so a decent pair of headphones will go to give you like another asset to the game. You'll be able to hear a lot more things going on than you're fully aware of in playing with just normal conventional speakers. The immersion in the game is second to none. It's very, very good. Chocolosh taking grenade fire there inside the compound. He's already hit. We've got a three-man breaching force here.
Future Force, BBN, Blackbird. If the Tokolosh can get himself sorted out, he can deal some serious damage here.
That was the doorway, straight into the prone position. BBN. A little bit of spray and pray, I think, there, but did the job.
They're certainly keeping their head back now. Counter suppression. Tokolosh, a slightly newer player, but seems to know exactly what it's doing.
It's all about covering the angles. The only downside to, as I said, to this is they may not actually come through that doorway. They could scale that wall if they utilise the new vaulting system. Fantastic nade. He's just took out two people. Injured a third, possibly. So
was that top loss?
I think so, yes. It's a great example of spacing. So even though they're all staged up, ready to breach, they were very close to one another.
Oh, again, putting more fire down on BBN. BBN's still trying to commit to that doorway.
So Vinny, 118, also coming from these western side.
Hold out, brothers. 20 minutes left before our comrades get in.
We've got more of those Russians pushing across the road from the west side as well.
So
a very lightly defended
bubbly
side.
Swagger. Doltress and Sebastian have managed to push all the way across in that field. Vox Legacy is now pushing back through the open field himself. I find it difficult that he hasn't seen any of those Russians coming across that field and it parallel to that Western.
Very unfortunate play. I'm guessing these fields probably have a lot more cover than we can expect.
And obviously the Russians completely unaware that they're being flanked from their rear.
Well,
MTLB.
Serious damage. It looks like the Russians have completely dominated the northern side of the city now. Yeah, only top class is the last.
The MTLB actually nudging the enemy techies out of the way.
And that's going to completely reduce Fox's ability to then get some kills, I would have thought.
With that armor being what it is, it puts the added risk but the reward is just as high. The Russians would think that they are safe, but they don't think that there's anyone behind them at this moment, so he could really come and put the cat amongst the pigeons here.
Here we go.
Chooses the nade option.
Unfortunate timing for Vox, they've both got in the building.
So three of them all stacked up in that building.
German heavy smoke to your northwest.
Literally half a meter between that grenade being absolutely devastating or just a complete waste. Unfortunate for Vox.
MCLB taking fire.
That's one hit on so far.
Fox takes out one of the infantry. Pushes back.
Vinny is down. Being very conservative there.
That western flanking force from the Russians has come under fire. The southern has managed to make its way into the middle of the compound right now. It's going to come across a lot of insurgent fire, crossfire as well.
So this is great play by the Russians. The insurgents, again, spreading themselves almost too thin on that northern side. And they're going to be, each insurgent is going to be facing two, three, or even four Russians with every building that they're trying to protect.
So the insurgents have managed to get another guy out to the far south as well, behind the Russian push. Enwin out there to the south. Vox Legacy choosing to utilize the roofs. Does he see that push to his right? He sees Don Poodle. Takes out Piano. Takes out BBN.
This could be very, very dangerous for the Russians.
Dominator also inside that compound.
Enwin pushing through from the back as well. This could be perfect timing. The Russians are in serious trouble at the moment.
So they're being penned in. They're just actually being herded. Dominator and Fell in the same building. What is going on? Dominator choosing the wrong time to patch. But again, the Russians are all in the same compound here. This is not what you want to be. You want to be spread around. You want to have that cover.
The Russians took a lot of damage there, a lot of casualties. Enough to slow them, and that confidence that they had pushing through from the north has just been completely dissipated. They've slowed right down.
The Vox Legacy has gone down there as well to the west, but Enwin is still alive to the south. He's taking shots on the Russians inside this compound now. Phoenix taking a hit. But the key now to the Russians is spacing. If they stack up too close to one another, a nade coming in here could be devastating.
An interest
like that.
Oh wow.
Yeah, an RPG round. In south of you.
That was a
taking Phoenix out.
A GL round, I believe. Three, keypad four, sub key five. It's in the middle of it. They're using the building as cover. The Russians trying to use that MTLB just to sweep around into the center of the compound, defending that second squad that pushed in from the south.
We've got Zeb and Doltrus with Ricky in the armor right near the objective now. Only a couple of insurgents on point to actually protect it. It's anyone's game still at the moment.
And we're still choosing to push that southern flank slowly but surely. Equally as the Russians advance up through the north.
Oh, Cloak! He had the drop on Doltrus and Zeb.
Now,
just couldn't quite get the shot off.
Leviathan is on the roof here, and he gets seen.
The Russians are playing this very, very well at the moment. Clearing, breaching. There's not a lot that the insurgents are going to be able to do. Black Panther on the south, still available.
So Enwin using the same kind of tactics as before. Engaging and running away.
Doltrus on the objective. Oh, a grenade out by Black Panther.
Now, depending on the kit, I believe that if you are as a normal rifleman, you will get two frag rounds in that loadout. But it would appear that we are going patch for patch at the moment. Black Panther patching as well as Sebastiu. So three Russians now on that AA, choosing to dig it up. On the fob as well.
Oh!
And that is why we talk about spacing.
Absolutely insane grenade.
So one left alive now on the point, who's also injured. He has no choice other to patch. Tossing a nade back. That nade goes out. So he is aware that there are insurgents. And another
Skaggy
frag.
Man out again.
So we have Don Poodle left alive. Ricky inside the armor.
Dildo's seen him. He's stalking him. Oh, that's GG for Don.
One left alive. Ricky now.
Edwin and Dildo. And we've also got Marrow and Black Panther still alive for the insurgents. Just Ricky. Again, we're in a very, very similar situation to the last game. I'm still active. Oh, that's another kill for the Russians.
Edwin a little bit upset with himself there. He had a little bit of a glitch, unfortunately, on the edge of that compound. His body was bouncing up and down, which is a shame.
He had a great opportunity to push from the north and really get some kills and make an impact, but I think he was just slightly too conservative just towards that, the last sort of 5 to 10 minutes when he should have been a little bit more aggressive.
So will we see the same kind of scenario happen here now as we saw in the first round, where the armoured driver has no choice other than to get out of the vehicle, push the objective?
So I can imagine he's probably getting himself clear so he can leave the vehicle, or at least get some good vantage points on the enemy infantry.
I mean, the engine sound alone gives you the insurgents
hold
the exact location.
Hold on, brothers, hold on. 10 minutes left before reinforcements arrive.
He's still inside the vehicle. Frag grenades coming over. Trying to bait him out, make him feel safe inside that armored vehicle.
It's not a nice situation for Ricky. He knows if he leaves, there's going to be shots on him almost straight away.
Dildo getting eyes on through the murder hole.
Great move. He switched the engine back on. He's exited the vehicle.
Eyes on the murder hole. Doesn't see Dildo because he's not peeking. He peeks. He takes him out. Great shot by Ricky.
Fantastic shot by Ricky.
Marrow on his west, Black Panther to his north. He knows where the FOB and the AA is. Now the Russians just need to take that out to secure this fight club.
A lot of pressure on Ricky right now. He must be feeling it. Great Please. Use of peeking. He's taking his time.
Suppressing Black Panther, but this is where Marrow should push in and take the kill.
He's doing it. You've called it.
Black Panther can't peek without being seen. Marrow should hear the shots and call it out.
There should be Marrows.
He's pushing away. He's flanking. He's pushing around. Where is he going?
Unbelievable aggression by Ricky. Grenade out. Unfortunate, but grenade.
Marrow could just shoot Ricky in the back right here. What is happening?
Black Panther's healing as well. He's not in a great position right now.
Now, again, utilization of sound. Ricky should be able to hear that patching.
Oh Ricky, unbelievable.
This guy's
Ricky
unstoppable.
Didn't even take a shot.
Marrow has just pulled off to the side of the point. Now choosing to crawl up. Ricky on the objective. 1v1. This is anyone's game. Choosing
surely
to shovel.
He's gonna hear this. Marrow's gonna hear this, surely.
Clearly not. He's just prone. Maro, what are you doing?
He's got us on the edge of our seats right now. What's he gonna do?
Slowly crawling. Ricky could have achieved this. That IA is nearly removed. Maro!
What's he doing?
How can he not hear this? AA, just a small part of that emplacement left. He's pushing! No, he's gone through!
I can't actually hear the shoveling from over where Maro is right now.
But he can't see the objective either. AA is removed. I believe that is successful Russian victory.
He's trying to play it safe. He's trying to play it safe. Maro pushing in at the wrong time right now. Unfortunate. That's GG for the insurgents. And
Maro now choosing to push back to the AA to see.
Unfortunate. Very, very unfortunate. He's going to be very disappointed with himself.
And we've had the announcement. Back. Yeah, Russian forces successful. Ricky managed to remove the anti-aircraft gun. And he's also exfilled from the main bay and the AO.
Unbelievable play by Ricky at the end there. MVP, certainly, for that game.
Great job by Ricky. Great job.
He was at a 4v1 at the end there. Perfect utilization of the vehicle, keeping the engine running at the perfect time. Maro clearly very disappointed in himself there. The frustration getting to him, he's shooting off rounds.
So, successful second round there this time by the Russian forces. We're going to go for a 10-minute break now, guys. We hope to see you for another couple of rounds. We're going to mix things up a little bit now and after the break.
Unbelievable.
Thank you.
Right, bear with me.
Stay down.
From the church.
He's down.
Yeah, come revise it.
We lost 18. We don't know.
Behind a small compound,
yeah, it was moving east of the target.
Enemy, 1 o'clock high, on hill, 1 o'clock high.
Light armor, got stronger. You said twice the height.
Far. It was
and
too fucking far.
Yeah, I know. You
it's
said twice the height
vehicle.
Of that. You said twice the height of that thing, and it didn't work. Shit.
It worked for me. And I landed low.
Somebody give it to somebody else. I mean, I'm not even looking through a range for landing. Landing short. Ah!
See, that was twice the height.
There we go. Who took that shot? You get middle of the fucking
yeah,
day.
But we
nice
need one
way.
More.
Yeah, we need one more rocket into that thing.
Oh
right now,
nice.
That shit is gone. Gone. Dave, you get the asshole of the mission. That's a good thing.
Come on.
Get it up.
Mark this.
I got
something else for Christmas too. Hang on. Here we go.
The guitar. Ah, ukulele.
So peaceful. Yeah.
Will there be a video? Make a video, man.
I'll make a video, Sammy.
Oh shit! Oh, everyone's here! Oh Christ!
Get out.
I got you, don't
he's
do
down.
That.
John,
I have a grenade in my hand and
you're going to
what
do
we do now?
Oh,
jeez.
We
got the cash back. Nice one, John.
That's terrible.
Game killed him.
Hey.
Do
it.
Guys,
you can fire into
Jamie
now.
Yeah, one thing. It's in there, you have the cash.
Bye. But this is a fob.
I don't know if it's a tree or an ambitious one.
Find the cash! Come on, find the cash!
cache in here.
This is the cache. This is the one. Oh my god.
Okay, if you can do it again.
All right, again. We're in now. Yeah, we can do it. Is he on? He's aiming for you.
What do you say? 202?
He's aiming for you.
Oh, he saw me.
Yeah, it sure did. Right in the head, too.
I didn't see him, but he saw me. Right, I don't think he's friendly, okay?
What
guys?
Do you do?
What makes you think that?
That's why you need to wear a helmet.
Big hole in my head.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah.
No, Nagash, he's here.
No bad guys, I'm
here. Oh, what the hell? Dude.
I can't lower right window.
How the fuck did you end up with that?
Help. Help.
Help. Getting off, buddy.
Oh, thank
don't
you.
Worry, Capital. You got three medics around you.
Three medics? I'll teach you a lesson about phasing.
Thanks.
To the moon.
Good luck with me.
On the road again. Yes, can't wait to get on the road again. Life is love is making you a good friend. And I can't wait to get on the road again.
Thank you.
Are you always making those YouTube videos?
Yes.
Yes,
yes. Yes, I am.
You need to make more of me in them. You're gonna make famous.
No, I'm not planning more of you, TMC. I don't want people to do bad.
We need new medics. Somebody grab the medic in place.
Happy.
You're in the TR, aren't you?
That's
cool. Yeah, I want a meteor thunder and a sound medic.
I'm too young to die. Clickpix, just stay there, mate. I want to be patched. I'm coming. Don't you fucking die on me. No, Clipix. The living first! Damn it!
Did you die?
I died!
MRAP scope is clear, I can't see anything.
Alright, medic, come here. I'm gonna smoke him out. Just throw a grenade up these stairs. Yeah.
Where else should we go?
Tossing it.
Ah, bad frag. Get out.
Oh shit, bad.
I guess train bridge.
Oh, fuck.
Until you die and respawn with us.
Classic.
So I'll throw a grenade on
me. Good word. Zah. Woo! Oh, it was inside the radio. Oh my god.
Out the way.
I want to walk in for the block. I think they're going to win.
They must too.
Oh, stop, Lexi! Get this SPG out! Get the SPG on the road! Everyone wait,
I'm ready.
Everyone wait. Wait for the AT to get in place. Hey, is that a hat? The vehicle!
Yes!
Another vehicle. Shitbox. Right.
Oh, we fucking roll, man.
There's a shitbox, same place. It's a BTR. Guys, that was awesome.
That was Medic. Great.
Are you truck? Lodgy? Come on, Rocket. Come out, Rocket.
Enemy Lodgy inbound side. Eyes on.
I hear
you. Last mover.
What, on a hit?
He's still moving. He's going fast. I'll hit the truck. Woohoo! Going fast, he's full.
Yeah!
Woohoo!
I got him, Pantero.
Welcome back to the live stream. After a very, very intense second round there, we saw that the Russians managed to win that one. So 1v1, and Ricky managed to sneak in there and take the victory just under the nose of defeat.
Hold on, I barely recovered. That was probably a little bit too intense for me.
So, yeah, they're looking to now switch things up again, and this will be the third round, so we're back to the original first round lineup, if you will.
So what can we expect from the third round now? Both sides have had a play with attacking and defending. I can imagine they both know what to look out for.
You would hope so. You'd hope that both teams now had an equal chance of both defending and attacking, would have gained a lot of experience and knowledge from that, so we can hope to see some interesting tactics used. Spacing was a bit lax, I found, on the Russian side on that second round. Hopefully they can be a bit more aware, which is quite strange, really, because as the first round, when they played as insurgents, their spacing was quite good. And they weren't stacked up all in one area. Let's see what they can bring to the table. So the squad, they're just getting their briefing now, final notes now, and we're going to be rolling out very shortly.
The confidence on the insurgent side now, with two wins under their belt, seems at an all-time high. So it'll be interesting to see how they play out this time, if they become a little bit more aggressive or not. What sort of conversations do you feel are going to be happening over with the Russian side at the moment, with two losses under them?
I think they just need to consolidate now. They need to really work together more as a team and their squads. Just instead of drip feeding into a compound, they need to be there ready to back the other person up. Be nice to see.
Stacking up, breaching, grenades, all the good stuff.
Lots more grenades needed, I feel. Yes. Not even just frag grenades, but even the utilisation of smoke, you know, either feigning a flank or utilising it to cover your movement across. So we're going live in about 10 seconds now, guys.
Just looking into the gameplay a little bit more, can you tell us a little bit about how the command structure would work in a scenario like this?
So essentially you're appointed as a squad leader, and then they will cascade the roles, the required kits, and then their utilization in the very plan that happens in these stages right now. So that, again, as we said before, they will have been given a location of where that asset is, and they will have to then plan accordingly who will be the attacking squad, who will be the defending squad, if they want to both attack simultaneously, who they want to appoint as point men. There's a lot more tactics involved than what just first meets the eye. You would try and utilise the usage of the specialised kits, so you would use the LATs with the frag rounds, for instance, to soften up the compounds maybe first, same as the GL kit, grenade launcher.
Right.
Try and soften the enemy or get them thinking a bit more about where the attack's going to be coming from or not come from, and just try and probe first before you actually make the full assault.
And some of these are actually quite advanced, very well experienced players as well, so we might even see some more of the experienced play coming out, such as Ricky with the use of the vehicle in the last game, turning it off for a while, turning it back on, then exiting. Fantastic use of the vehicle, which initially was a hindrance because he couldn't get out of it, really came to his advantage later on in the game.
I think he was lucky that they had just as few insurgents left alive on the point. I think if there were a few more left, he wouldn't have been so successful.
4v1, the end of the game was a very, very intense end. I certainly wouldn't have put my money on Rookie. Phenomenal outcome.
So the compound again has been changed for the insurgents for the location of their emplacement. The MTLB is at the rear this time, whereas the Russians choosing to push straight in with a transport truck, almost coming straight into contact with an insurgent early on.
Nadja's certainly going to have eyes on that. He's going to be seeing them. Oh, well, that's a large number getting out as well.
So that's a full squad versus one insurgent, but then there's also some others stacked up on the wall.
Annoying.
Those guys, straight away they have eyes on the Russian movement. Nadja getting brave as well, moving in.
See. Snug End coming to the south. Did he just... Snug End has eyes on. He's called it out to his squad members. This is where the first engagement is going to go down. Tokoloshmai seeing through the murder hole. Nadja slowly crawling.
I think he knows he's a bit outnumbered there. He's going for the low ground, getting himself some cover.
Oh gosh, peeking that murder hole. Future force on that compound.
That was a very wide grenade there, I think.
Akalosh. Good placement on that murder hole. However, it would appear that the Russians are just setting themselves up in that compound, waiting for the second strike force to be in place.
Very nice play by the Russians. Quite almost what appeared to be an aggressive start, which is getting a nice forward position and then playing slightly conservative until the time's right.
But their momentum has slowed to almost a stop now. Nadja probing, just he is aware that there's a full squad in that area, so we can see Easy, Cloak and Leviathan down to the south. And
it's going to be a painstaking crawl through that field, surely.
Black Panther in the MTLB again, eyes on, straight into the MSR, into the compound. If any of those insurgents peek that corner, he's got that covered straight away.
Great position. Vox and Dildo look again to be playing. Looks like seemingly there's some flanking or some scouting positions. A long way from the AO. Back up in the north. Nadja still laying prone in the field. This hasn't been a successful tactic previously, Holland. What are his options here?
When he's on his own, there's not a lot he can do. He hasn't got anyone around from his team that can cover him if he does get into engagement. He may just be the sacrificial lamb, if you will. He could be the early warning sign to give the rest of the team an indication of the size of the force that will be pushing from that location. He's obviously given intel already to the guys on his team that they've seen a full squad push up in that location with the transport truck. He has yet to see any movement out from that area. So even if he does go down, he's given the team more intel just by the sacrifice of his life.
A value well rewarded, definitely.
The MTLB choosing to push up slightly there, obviously as the infantry have moved up on the hill, the field, sorry, to the west. Very surprised Black Panther has not seen an infantry peak yet. See, Doltress just peeking around the edge if the MTLB was to move forward just a little bit more.
Oh, that's a hit from the lat. Return fire, but it doesn't look like he knows what he's shooting at. Was
one
that a miss?
Miss.
That a
hit? One hit, one miss. So the first fire was drawn in by the insurgents.
Black Panther pulling that vehicle out of there. Right move. Yep. A very good move.
That's right.
That's less cloak, easy, and Leviathan without any support on their own. City solo.
So they've also got some frags coming out on the west flank where we saw that.
There's a heavy concentration of infantry from the insurgents on this side.
So we're seeing a lot more utilization of smoke right now. Nades coming over, cloak goes down. Two nades in the same area, taking the two guys out. Leviathan also heavily damaged. They need to watch their spacing if they're going to storm these compounds. They cannot get in without spacing.
That's a huge loss of momentum for the Russian side early on.
The NTLB just putting some suppression down on these compounds. Naja is still alive in that field, even though there's a lot of smoke being pushed out from that area.
This is a huge push from the Russian force.
Flanking along the north. Tokolosh has gone down, though, on that push. Future Force and Vinny to the north, they're covering those fields. Smoke going out there from Goost as well.
So it looks like they've opened two additional points of attack. It looks like the Russian forces here in the north are going to be pushing what looks like northeast to hit from the east side.
Possibly, even though they've inserted on the western flank, they're going to come all the way across on the north, trying to flank down the east.
That's a strong push by Goost. He's straight in.
He is between two insurgents, though, on this.
Vinny and Future Force. And they're both aware as well. They know he's there. So it also looks like Black Panther has abandoned the ship box. He's with Leviathan on the south flank.
So he's made good ground there, pushing up on foot.
Has he abandoned the armor? Has he left it behind completely? He has. Do you feel that that's a wise move?
It's a risk. For sure, because obviously he hasn't got that long-range support anymore for this team. I could only imagine that that's been a mutual agreement between the squad as well. It wouldn't have been a decision they'd have made lightly. They'd have found that the close quarters nature of the combat felt that it was necessary to be on the ground as opposed to long-range. Too many compounds in this flag, I imagine.
That would make sense. And the road leading up to the city as well, it's an alleyway of death, surely, for an RPG to go down there. There's
very much a bottleneck, yeah. Smoke's coming out again from the Russian team. Nice usage this round. Nice.
Naja still up in the north.
So it would appear that the squad that got into the northwest early on have split into two fire teams now. We've got a three on the east, three on the west. Piano fights pushing through the field to the northeast. Will he come behind? See these three Russians pushing through the open field.
Nadja doing something very, very similar still. Still up in the north. He could have a great angle on uninspiring the two other Russians on this side. Dominator and Goose, they could be in trouble here. Someone's going down within the next 30 seconds on this north side.
Dominator choosing to take the first shots there. Saw Nadja just skylining on that ridge line. Nadja choosing to come back and peek.
He's getting confident.
Hey.
Probably a wise decision to fall back there, I think. He's done his job. He's distracted them. He's lured them away. He's kept his life.
So, Calzone, Enwin, and Six Shot managing to successfully push all the way around on that eastern flank now. Gone in unseen, but they are going to come into contact with Reaper, Bernie, Skeggy Man, and Don Poodle in that compound. Again, this is where the sound levels come into effect. Hearing the sound of movement.
And we know from the previous games that these four players have all got kills. I know what they're doing. They're experienced players.
I'm going to nade over.
They're already calling out. They can hear contacts inside the compound, and they're nading.
Frag out.
One nade out, no kill, second nade. Skaggy Man is down.
Also hear the confirmation of the kill as well, by the death scream. Players give up. So the armoured vehicle is back in play now, but being driven by Dildo McBaggins. So there must have been a handoff from that armoured vehicle.
Probably rightly so as well. I think Dildo and Vox were in the southwest. Previously as scouts, and it looks like they've come back to bring the armor back into the game. Probably just with Union as well.
Six Shot and Kelzone choosing to breach this compound to remove those entrenchments.
Don Poodle taking a shot at Dildo in the armor, unsuccessful. Six shots down. Reaper, great kill. I think the Russians still have a long way to go, but they're certainly making progress. Uninspired, he's got his own compound under control. Trixie's moving in.
Dildo being asked to assist with a bit of suppression there on that compound. Don Poodle takes out Calzone. Because that compound has come under increasing concentration of fire at the moment, that may give the Russians the impression that the asset is in that compound. So
that would make sense. That would make a huge amount of sense. Uninspire is actually near, very, very near the objective. In fact, he may have already got eyes on.
See BB in there. See on guard. Unspire needs to call it in. Gonna call it in. The attack needs to come now.
This could be cut very, very short, a lot sooner than expected, if Uninspired plays this right.
Yeah, I'm gonna head around this building here.
I'm guessing he's called for backup. He's just waiting for that backup to come now.
Unspire doing the wise thing there and waiting for reinforcements rather than pushing that objective on his own.
Again, we've talked about this before, Holland, patience is really, really key. This is a perfect time to use that. He's in a very, very nice position at the moment. Dildo cutting off a really nice number of infantry from actually staying in the fight as well. Probably little does he know it. But he's cut off 5-6 insurgents from actually rushing back to the target if needed. Do you think Uninspire is likely to get that support that he needs on the objective?
He needs to see what's going to happen for the rest of the team at the moment. Pixie's under a lot of fire. She also has an enemy right behind her inside that compound.
It looks like she knows as well. Yeah, she can definitely hear that.
Dildo choosing to take out one of the enemy assets. Technical. Inspired, feeling brave, oh, pushing.
Trixie taken out back from the back. By Winsky.
Inspired taking out BBN, so that 50 AA emplacement is now open. Will we see some of the insurgents push back to the north to defend that? All he has to do
already
is remove that emplacement. Going to cover the door.
The insurgents certainly know that he's there.
Two insurgents now converging simultaneously on that point. One from the north, one from the south. Unspire taking cover inside that building. Will he hear Phil?
Unspire completely missed him. Completely missed Phil. Move in on the objective. The odds are massively against Unspire at the moment.
Vinny then obviously feeling that the flag is the objective is secure. Move back up.
Oh! Uninspire got the first shot off, but Fell gets the kill shot.
Good play there, boy Phil.
Very, very good play.
Dildo making himself a bit of a nuisance there on the north side. How many Russians do we have left alive on the point?
It looks like no Russians are still alive near the objective. I think Dildo might be the last remaining Russians still alive on the field.
Okay, so insurgents have to converge again now and push that to MTLB. Always the MTLB that seems left alive at the last part of the match. This is the third time we've seen such a scenario unfold.
Interesting, and is it that each squad and obviously each side, each country playing two squads? Does each squad get a anti-tank infantry or?
Again, without knowing the squad briefing and the loadouts that they're chosen, I can't. I'll give you the accurate information on that, but by the sounds of what we've heard at the early stages of the round, it would appear that there are two LATs in play, one on either squad, but they do not have a ammo box, so they cannot resupply, so they have to make those hits count early on.
So that's four shots essentially to take out an armor and missing model,
which is more than enough.
It's going to render the armor almost invincible.
But again, the difficulty is that the armor cannot get where the asset is.
It looks like at the moment, just doing a quick counter, Dildo has 8 enemies to take out at the moment. The odds aren't looking good.
Is he choosing to leave the armor at range and push in on foot.
Hold on, if you're in this situation, what would you do?
It's a difficult one for sure, but there's nothing you can do inside that vehicle, so you've got no alternative but pushing on. Fortunately, the odds are against him. He's not to know that, but as a single player, unless you are very, very good, isn't it? Vinny choosing to push the, obviously, that MTLB now, hear the engine sound, whereas Dildo is flanked in opposite direction, south. He will come contact with any, if not, on Poodle from.
I think Bernie is very nicely tucked behind that wall. Unless Bernie starts peeking, I think Dildo's safe. Vinny, still no idea that the ship box is unoccupied.
To get eyes on from that murder hole, then onto John Poodle.
But he has given his position away. Do you think that was a good move for Dildo?
Moves position and relocates, yes. Keep the enemy guessing. John Poodle looking now back through that murder the window. Refusing to go downstairs. Bernie held up in that corner.
A lot of movement from the insurgents now. This could be it. Oh, that's GG.
Reaper managed to get the shot off.
Great kill by Reaper.
So the insurgents win that round again. Great job. We'll be back in another 5 minutes. Let's take a quick break.
See you soon.
Hang, you need a rocket? I got a rocket. Tell me where to shoot. I fucked up.
Don't switch to struggle.
Left, there's a habit.
What the hell?
The prize, motherfucker!
Nice.
Alright, there's enemies around here, guys. There's enemies around. Jump out. Lovely, jubbly.
Ah. Every militia in
take
an
army back, guys. Don't fail me. Watch the FOP. Right, everybody else can for now respawn at the FOP. Watch out when you're going out to the FOP. Enemies are watching the FOP.
Do you ever get car sick? Like looking backwards? Have you ever sat on a bus with the, you know, the seats are in the other way around?
Doesn't bother me.
We're so close. Are you sure you want to be this close?
This is
oh my God.
What are we doing here? Oh, just drive through the lane. Holy crap. Oh, shit. Man, your ass is on fire. Holy shit. Oh, he dropped off.
Very close.
Watch out, Grex.
Yeah. Fuck it. We're gonna go to Farmstead. We're neutralizing Farmstead.
Okay, that was pretty cool.
Next try.
You know, this is the most realistic part of the game.
Hello,
just
Lexi.
Doing labor. That's what I remember from the army.
From the Relic movie, not Courtyard.
Did I just lose connection? Or is everyone just standing still?
No, no, we're just standing still.
Okay. I was wondering.
There's a building truck there.
Okay.
Thanks.
The building up behind refinery. On the open side.
The polar ice caps have melted.
What the hell?
Covering the earth with water.
There it is. Let's get a bit closer. We know it's gonna go down the hill. So let's get ice.
Yeah, yeah.
Yep.
What is sword maga?
Count.
Alright. 3, 2, 1, fire.
He's northeast of the router. It's pretty hot.
Taking shots.
Please just go to the third one at least.
Got it! Yes! Yes!
Oh, come on!
Oh, you missed the game!
Oh my god.
Yeah, got him!
Is there anything behind the ham? That's what they're using currently.
I swear you said there's an elephant behind the ham.
He did.
That's your mama.
Whoa. Enemies pushing up on the transport truck up the river.
Oh, a beater just spawned in front of us.
Forget it, we need a form of vehicle.
Alright.
But it's so shiny.
It kills.
I know, you like shiny.
Guys,
don't
even think it's a good one,
shiny.
I don't think they like us being here.
I don't know why
either. What the fuck is wrong with it?
They're just breaking the windows. It's gonna add more cost to repairs.
Fucking hooligans.
Totally barbaric.
So we're back now, guys. We're going to have another couple of minutes waiting time while the guys get ready to set up for the fourth and final round, I believe, of this evening. It's been some interesting games, some nice tactics used.
Some very, very interesting play, Holland. Really interested to see what the last half of the game is going to bring. That's now three wins for what was the insurgent side, but next is going to be the Russian side. Is that correct?
That's correct, mate, yeah. So they've definitely got the winning tactic, however they choose to employ it.
What do you think the perfect formula for winning this game type is?
It's a difficult one because obviously they're not playing the same compound each time they switch sides. So I'm not sure if it's the compounds that lend favour or the utilisation of squad technique. It's probably a multitude of all the different factors, really. Some prefer to use the MTLB in close quarters as well. Some prefer long-range engagements, keeping the enemy suppressed. It's a difficult one, really. Without actually being there and playing it yourself, it's easy to speculate and judge from the outside.
Yeah, definitely. I'd 100% agree. And I think one of the most important elements of this game is probably in its name, squad. Teamwork is, I think, from you and I both playing the game, one of the most important things that you can really ascertain and really get to grips with. Because you can have 9 of the best players in the game, but if they don't cooperate, if they don't work as a team, then they're essentially useless.
The cooperation is on different facets, though. It's not necessarily about being the best shooter. It's, as we were saying earlier, having Nadja out there on that northwest flank. He could be utilised as just a point man for information. You know, having that fed back then to the team is worth more than somebody who's a good shot on their own.
100%, definitely.
So it's how you choose to use your guys to your benefit as well. And the more you get to play with certain people time and time again, the more you get to know their strengths and their abilities and how they're better off for the squad and ultimately the team's victory. This event's slightly different, being in a one life event and obviously a fixed objective. Traditionally, the game is played over capture points, so there'll be a series of flags dedicated on the map, and they will have to be taken over by one faction or the other. The majority of flags capped by a faction has a ticket bleed on the other side, and then ultimately the tickets are gained by kills, but then also, as we talked about earlier, losing FOBs and assets such as vehicles. So the game can be over very quickly if you just throw everything at an objective without thinking about what you're actually trying to do.
Of course. And obviously, this game, it already feels so smooth, especially compared to some of the other games in the market at the moment, with it only just being an alpha stage. But what more do you see coming from Squad?
There's a lot in the works. The devs are really keen to keep everybody in the community up to date with what's working and in the background as well. So they'll have a monthly feedback of what's happening as well. One of the recent additions as well since the version 10 patch is the introduction of the Steam Workshop. So the game supports mods as well now. There is not a great deal of mods available at this current moment in time, but what is available, there are some really good game modes and different maps to play that are differ from the standard. So I do advise that you check out the Steam Workshop for Squad as well. But they also take part in the modding wrench as well, which gives you the information about what is being worked on in the background from the community side as well from the Steam Workshop. So it's not just the game itself, there's the modding side, which is a whole other side to the game.
So it's going to be essentially completely open to the community to change, because you and I both know from previous games, some of the most well-scripted games that are out there, having that sort of open back end really opens the game up to allow the community to essentially interact. So do you see some of the biggest changes coming from the community or from the developers?
I think it'd be nice to see a collaboration of both. What we have seen is the really strong community maps will be implemented as full version maps in the game, which I think is a nice, wow. It's a nice nod of the hat to the community modders. Project Reality in itself was a mod to Battlefield 2. So the devs for Squad are aware of its lineage and what it takes to make a decent mod to a game, and then to have that implemented as a full-fledged game. It's quite an honour, really, quite a privilege.
Yeah, I can imagine. Wow. And it's such a smooth game. Such a smooth game.
The gameplay has changed dramatically since version 10. I keep saying that, but it for a lot of people, it feels like a completely different game now. It's still the game we know and love. You know, the game modes are still the same. The kits, it's just how it's now implemented, how you utilise that. It's a fresh look at it, which is what was needed.
If you could describe Squad in three words, what would it be?
Oh, don't put me on the spot like that. tactical, immersive, and I can't think of a third.
Awesome.
Enthralling, really. It's the game that has kept my interest peaked for the longest period of time than any other game previously that I've ever played. And that's like including AAA games and stuff. So that, is a real high praise, is such that you can keep the interest of a player there for as many hours. I mean, I've seen some Squad players that have got, 4,000 hours and stuff already. And this is a very early access game. It's not something that's fully fleshed out yet. There's still lots more to come. So if the people like it that much already, that you can only imagine what will be on full release.
Incredible. And this is probably a really speculative question, Holland, but do you see it coming to console? That's probably the question of the community who are watching this and who aren't on PC or on Steam availability are going to be asking.
I doubt that from the very early outset, because as you were saying earlier, because it is so smooth, the graphics and the processing power that's needed, arguably on next-gen consoles maybe, but at this current moment in time, because the game's not optimised as it is, it could not be ported to console. And it's designed for PC game players, really. You notice the difference. It's not like any other console ported game. It's not a Battlefield, you know. It's not Call of Duty. It's its own thing. Without wanting to keep it exclusive, you need to play it on a PC to understand as to why. The best thing to do is, if you're interested in a game like this, is to keep your eye on it on the Steam store. Put it on your wish list. It does come up for sale every now and again. There will be also free weekends. Just try it. See what you think.
Nice. Yeah, I would agree 100%. Definitely. The immersiveness of Squad, especially if you're a first-person shooter, if you like your tactical games, you really can't get it anywhere else. You really can't.
For me, it felt like it filled the void between games such as Battlefield, as they started to get a little bit more arcadey, if you will, in their playstyle.
Yes.
Whereas something like a military tactic shooter like Armor, it can be a little bit daunting, steep learning curve for some people. Squad fills that middle ground, I find. It's not too difficult to pick up, but it also has that realism factor that you can play the game, you know, within a reason, within certain military tactics. You can't ultimately utilize formations and serious military tactics in this game. It is still somewhat arcadey in its aspects, but version 10 has slowed the pace down a lot. Before then, there was a lot of run-and-gun tactics, rushed metas. It's a completely different game now. It's very fresh.
Excellent. As somebody who's actually come from the Armor community myself as well, stepping into the Squad community, I think it massive difference, even within the community itself. So the community which surrounds the Squad game is very, very different. And I think the statistics show as well that a large number of Armor players have migrated over to the Squad community and to the Squad game simply because of how immersive it is, and the community that surround it as well. Communities such like RIP as well, which are very welcoming to outsiders. And again, if you haven't checked it out, head over to the RIP forum, get yourself signed up and check it out.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, even if you're not interested in becoming a member, you're welcome to play alongside us on our public servers within the week. And once a week on a Friday evening around 6 o'clock in the afternoon UK time, we'll have RIP versus the World, which is the only day in the week where we stack on one team and we challenge any members of the public or other clans to just, yeah, give us a bit of a fight.
Amazing. And there's always stuff going on within the RIP clan as well. Can you tell us about sort of any upcoming events or weekly events that you do? I know you mentioned the RIP versus the World on Fridays. What else does RIP offer?
We also hold internal trainings for our members. And then we also have, because we are fortunate enough to be one of the larger communities within Squad, we have over 260 members currently. We are able to field a full match team for an internal skirmish as well. Obviously,
that's insane numbers.
Yes. The fight club that you see before you is one of hopefully many future events planned as well in the works. We've got lots of other things without giving too much away. We're going to see the feedback from the event from our members and then see what we can do with that in the future. Yes, we are hoping to have lots more stuff planned for you in the future.
Amazing. So this is, Holland, essentially the last round we're coming up to now?
I believe the round is finished.
So that's GG.
By just looking at the scoreboard on the server, I think that's it. We are at an end.
Holland, thank you very much for having me on tonight. Again, just to reiterate, this is my only... I've only been in the RIP clan for just over a month, so to have an opportunity to commentate with someone of your caliber is an honour. Thank you very much.
Thank you, mate, for stepping as well. Successful first stream. Hopefully the start for many more.
Look forward to it. Thanks for having me.
Thanks, mate. Catch you soon, guys.